Hey guys, welcome back. So in today's video, I am going to be fixing the dining room. I am donating these chairs, and if you want to know why, then check out my previous dining room video when I unboxed them. Trust me, you will understand exactly why I'm donating them. I will have that video linked in the description box. But anyways, before I bring back in my old chairs, I'm gonna go ahead and clean the floor. Today's video is sponsored by Best Buy, and I am gonna be using their Bissell Crosswave X7 Cordless Pet Pro Vacuum. This is a multi-surface wet dry vac, and I'm really excited about it. I'll talk a bit more about the vacuum when I start using it, but right now I just wanna clear out the space, get this table out of the way so I can vacuum and wash the floor and then bring out my area rug. So let's go ahead and finish up with that. Go ahead and use the vacuum now. I love that it comes with this docking station so you can charge it up. One thing I don't enjoy doing is mopping, so I don't have to worry about that with this one because I can vacuum and wash the floors at the same time. You can also do your area rugs. You can use it on a lot of different floor types like sealed wood floors, vinyl, laminate, linoleum, and many more. I'm going to go ahead and fill the water tank with the cleaning solution that it comes with. The back of the tank has fill lines to let you know how much water and cleaning solution to use, and it smells really good. It is also a multi-surface cleaner, so that's great. Now when you get ready to use it, you do have your power button at the bottom. The trigger on the back of the handle is what you will use to spray out the solution. So if you don't want to wash, just vacuum, then just tilt the handle back and vacuum your floors. None of the solution is going to come out until you press that trigger. Now to change the mode, all you have to do is press the top button and you can select which surface you're going to be vacuuming or washing. This has a digital display and you will see the icons for an area rug, hard floors, and then it has the turbo pet mode. I don't have a pet, but I do have kids, and sometimes they can get really messy, especially when they're playing with paint. I mean, I tell them not to play with paint on the carpet, but sometimes they don't listen. So if a spill happens, then I can just use the turbo mode for just like that extra deep clean. The runtime on this vacuum is up to 30 minutes, which is a good amount of time. I can do multiple rooms in 30 minutes, so that's great. One of the features that I really love is the LED headlights. When you press the trigger for washing the floors, the LED headlights will turn blue. That lets you know the solution is coming out, so that's a really nice feature. This vacuum also comes with a self-cleaning cycle, so when you're done using it, you just dump out your dirty water and just make sure your tank is filled to the clean out cycle line and just run a cycle. It takes about 40 seconds. So overall, I think this is a great product. I love using it and I'm just really happy that it can do both vacuum and wash your floors or your carpet at the same time. If you're interested in getting your hands on this product, click the link in the description box, and they are running a promotion right now so you can save up to $100 on select Bissell vacuums. So definitely check it out, guys. All right, now that I am done washing the floor, I couldn't believe it was so dirty. It didn't even look like it was dirty, but yeah, this vacuum did a really good job cleaning. But I'm gonna go ahead and bring out the area rug that I used to have in this space. I took it out because it just didn't look right with my wall decor, but I did switch out the art and I'm gonna try it again and see how I like it. The rug was starting to fade a bit and it didn't look quite right, so that's another reason why I just went ahead and put it in storage, and I don't have any other spaces around the house to use it in. So I'm gonna give it another try and see how I like it. I am in the process of decluttering the house and getting rid of a lot of stuff that I really don't need anymore. So I'm gonna see if this rug is gonna be another item that I need to go ahead and get rid of. I didn't clean this rug before putting it in storage, so I am gonna use the vacuum on it as well and just get up any dirt or stains that might be on it. Thank you. All right, guys, so I have my old chairs and my old rug back in the space, but I don't like the way this rug looks with the art. It's definitely starting to fade, and some areas are turning, like, I feel like it's turning kind of pink. I mean, you might not be able to tell on camera, but like, I feel like this rug used to have white in it, but now I don't really see any of the white. It's just, I'm not crazy about it, and I definitely don't like the way it looks with this art. I was gonna put this back up, but yeah, this rug doesn't look good with either of these pieces. All right, so it's been a few days and I actually stopped recording to see if I could find a new rug. I went to Home Depot, Tuesday morning, Lowe's, just a bunch of different places, and I didn't have any luck. It's probably a good thing that I didn't buy a new rug because I really don't need one in this space. I would like to have one. I think it'll look really nice, but I don't need it. So I just decorated the room without the rug and it still looks fine. It's not something you actually need in a dining room. I just like the way it looks under the table. Alright, so I am done with the space and I pretty much just put it back to how it used to be. The same pieces. I mean, I switched out some of the decor. But anyways, let me take you around the room and tell you where I picked up some of the stuff in case you're new here and you want to know where things are from. Let's start off with the table. I always get questions about this table. I got it from Pier 1 online, but it's not available anymore. I purchased it maybe like 4 years ago. But yeah, I cannot find it on the website anymore. The chairs are from Amazon. This tray here, I believe that is from Home Goods. And I have this vase that's from Kirkland's. This floral arrangement you can find on Amazon. This candle is from Italics. This is from Ross, this little succulent plant there. The lamps are from Ross as well. And this piece here, I believe I got that at Ross. Or Home Goods, I can't remember. This box, so cute. I love this fluted design. This is from Home Goods. This plant is from QVC and it looks very realistic. I love it so much. I do incorporate real plants around the house, but I also like the fake ones as well. I suck at keeping like flowers alive for long, but I can manage with bigger plants. But yeah, I like to incorporate real and fake around the house. The planter, that I believe I got that from Home Goods, and you saw me switch out the bowl so I can put the planter inside of the stand because I wanted to raise it up a bit higher. But that set was from Ross. The art is from Home Goods. I really love this piece, and the console table is from Amazon. So yeah. Oh, and this mirror is from Home Goods. So yeah, that is all I've decided to do with this space. Keep it pretty simple, but I hope you guys enjoyed watching. If you did, give this video a thumbs up. If you're not already subscribed, I would love it if you'll do so. That'd be so awesome, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye, guys.